Ryuichi, Brave Souls, News, Ladies and Gentlemen, and Leaks, Thousand Year Blood Warfare Return, and so much more leaks. But before to start, remember to share thank you, arigato, Hiken-sama, to share the information with us, so much cheers and thanks to Hiken. And now let's see the information, we have a lot of info. We have leaks for new attack, new skill, release type that is coming for end of month that I'm gonna share with you. We have resurrections, also the new swimsuit resurrections, finally! Yoruichi and Orihime resurrected, Kukakutu. And also we have new banners, Thousand Year Blood Warfare Return, the Ichigo Chatanuryu, and some random seasonal banner that is coming too. Also the news about the character packs, as always, every resurrection got the character pack later. Thousand Year Blood Warfare is not the exception, we're gonna got that Thousand Year Blood Warfare characters packs. I'm gonna be able to do my Toshiro 5/5 because it's 4/5 with that. And also next month we're gonna got, in 2 weeks probably, the swimsuit character packs, for if you are interested about it. So those are the news about the packs. Summons, which summons are coming? Conquer summons, Thousand Year Blood Warfare Return. When? We don't know. Fillers? We don't know. We still don't know when the summons gonna drop or which fillers gonna have, but gonna be before end of month, so yeah, I suppose that gonna be 25, 27, something like that, maybe 25 or 27, maybe 28. I think that gonna be probably 27, the same day as the Bankai Live gonna be, so probably on 27, the Ichigo Return, I guess that gonna be 27, but it's just personal opinion, we don't know yet the fillers, we don't know yet when gonna return. When gonna be, I'm gonna share with you the fillers and all the stuff. So, Concord Ichigo Return. Here we have the info, and also we have a seasonal cycle summons here to God Yumichika, Aizen and Neliel. This information is already in-game, so if you go in-game you can see the fillers and all the stuff. I think that is not interesting banner, it's a skip, at least personally in my opinion. But if you wish to invest your hours here, do as you wish. Those are the news about the banners, Thousand Year Blood Warfare Conquer Return, and also the first step, it's free, remember, the step 1, gonna be free, so you have a free chance to go to Ichigo, Uryu, or chat. I recommend to do step 3, and bye-bye, maximum one more step if it's discounted, but save for end of month, because end of month could be something big. Why? Because we have a Bankai Live, I posted video yesterday that I'm gonna put on the description the prediction about end of month. We have a Bankai Live, a special Bankai Live, Quincy's versus Soul Reapers. So looks as is Thousand Year Blood Warfare focused. Probably new Quincy's or new Soul Reapers gonna drop end of month. Gonna be announced on the Bankai Live on 27, next Sunday. 27, yep. And here we have information about new attack, leaks about new attack type and its release. And it's related game object machine gun. So it's a new attack type, for example, the strong trap or the charged one, it's a different attack type. And then new related object machine gun. Machine gun probably it's related with BG9, the Quincy that fights versus Soifon and that use some kind of machine guns or projectiles, I guess, that gonna be related with that. That presumably spawns a machine gun alley, so probably gonna be related with BG9, at least in my opinion, with its own special gauge, attack count and attack area. So the machine gonna have own special gauge, attack count and area. So maybe machine gun, the BG9 Quincy gonna summon a machine gun that gonna be around moving and gonna increase your gauge or something. Sounds crazy and sounds so much as BG9 is coming for end of month. Maybe with other Quincy's Stand Riders, maybe with us not, maybe with Soifon Mukui Shunko remake. We will see, end of month could be something crazy. I am angry because the previous end of month and the anniversary was crazy and a lot of players now have orbs, but it's annoying. Wow, another chance for that new skill machine gun, maybe Grammy? Maybe Grammy gonna summon a machine gun, so maybe Grammy and Kenpachi remake? I doubt so much, directly related with the Kur 2 and the battle that happened at the previous episode. But yeah, it's a chance, machine gun from Grammy. And maybe Grammy gonna summon a machine gun and gonna be around. Let me doubt, I feel more as BG9, but it's a chance. We not have date for Conquer summons yet, guys. Remember, no date for that summons, no fillers. And the date for the end of month gonna be revealed on 27 on Bankai Live. And we have this news about the machine gun, so potentially BG9 coming with maybe other Stand Riders, as not, as Grammy, a lot of Stand Riders, a lot of chances could be Quincy's, could be Kilge, could be Jugram remake, could be a lot of ones. And also could be Soul Reaper remake as Soifon, because was the ones that fight versus BG9. But all of that is prediction. The banner gonna be revealed on 27 on Bankai Live next Sunday, and we're gonna be here on the channel making a live stream and reacting the news. So this is the information for the end of month, the leaks that we have that could be potentially BG9, the information about the banners, and the last news that keep here to see and to share with you. It's the Swimsuit Resurrections. We're gonna drop the Resurrections on 28, that's gonna be next Monday. So maybe on 28 gonna drop the Concord Summons, maybe not gonna be 27 and could be 28 with the Resurrections. Makes sense, so keep on mind. Probably Concord Summons dropping 27-28 on my opinion, prediction. Then, Swimsuit Resurrections, Orihime, Yoruichi and Kukaku. Personally, I'm very happy for that. So much, man, for real. I love the characters and I waited so much that Resurrections, mainly the sexy Orihime, on Yoruichi, because I use a lot for speedruns. So Yoruichi Resurrections, no have innate skill sadly, but wins a strong attack damage on soul traits, so increase about damage. No Havoc, damage to weakened enemies 20%, it's kind of increased, but no disabler, so this is gonna be hard to got, but at least it's here, and increase also for the soul bomb. No Havoc, no Berserk, only strong attack damage on the soul trait, and long stride. Very interesting that this Yoruichi wins long stride, so it's a big win for me on my speedruns, because gonna be very fast Yoruichi that I'm gonna enjoy so much using, and gonna save me one bonus ability. I'm gonna be able to put a sprinter and full stamina or other bonus abilities. So very interesting resurrection in my opinion. So to keep happy for Yoruichi, just keep in mind that no innate skills, no Havoc, so it's a very worst resurrection compared with the Thousand Year World Warfare previous ones, compared with Toshiro that wins Havoc, damage, SP up, or Mayuri, or Nemu. So the resurrection is not on the level on the Thousand Year World Warfare ones, but it's still a win for me for long stride and more damage, damage to weakened enemies and soul trait strong attack damage. But it's not a crazy super good resurrection, but at least long stride, I'm very happy for that. Then later Orihime Chuan recovery 16% between quest areas. What the fuck is this shitty soul trait? But yeah, it is what it is, just eat. Long reach, frenzy, weakened defense that was already there, slow duration, bruiser, devastation, sprinter, no havoc, no berserk, no extra damage, just damage inflicted to full stamina 20%. Some interesting damage for the soul bomb, so Orihime just win damage to full stamina 20% and recovery. It's a very bad resurrection, it's ridiculous, but it is what it is. I waited so much that Orihime wish it havoc here and more damage, that full stamina damage is not bad, but havoc is disgusting. Also Yoruichi, no havoc, it's super bad. And then Kukaku Chuan, let's see if Kukaku is shafted or no. Kukaku, wow, crazy link, strong attack damage, inflicted full stamina 20%, that's crazy link, it's a 40% link, it's a very good link, that Kukaku. So it's an interesting new damage here, 20%. Cooldown 12% on the skills, that's a very interesting cooldown skill. So Kukaku was not shafted at all, I like it. No have havoc, no have berserk, but have this 20% full stamina strong attack and cooldown 20%. It's a very interesting resurrection in my opinion, that cooldown 20%, but Orihime was shafted and just the full stamina 20%. I like that Kukaku 12%. I hope that that resurrection, some kind similar, gonna be the Grimmjow Can't Fear Your Own Wall, to wins more damage, to wins cooldown and also some kind of havoc, should be amazing for Grimmjow. So I hope that the Can't Fear Your Own Wall Grimmjow from round 1, the Beyond Resurrection, gonna be similar as that Kukaku. And Yoruichi, very nice with long stride. Sadly, no havoc on any resurrection, but it is what it is. Welcome to Caleb Games. They like to shaft our lovely characters, mainly Orihime, one of the sexiest or the sexiest Orihime in game, and just full stamina 20. But it is what it is, ladies and gentlemen. The resurrection's gonna drop on 28. Remember, next Monday, in 1 week, and it's gonna be 75 orbs for each resurrection. So if you have the three characters, 225 orbs. Very nice, I'm happy for the resurrections and the news, just not for the Quincy's coming for end of month, because we not have orbs, I not have orbs, and a lot of players no have orbs after a lot of summons on the anniversary and Thousand Year World Warfare and all. And looks as another Thousand Year World Warfare banner is coming, maybe a broken one with BG9. We will see, remember 27 Bankai Live, and we will discover there. And about Concord Summons, I think that's gonna be 27 or 28, potentially 28 with Resurrections, makes more sense that it's gonna drop on 28. Those are all news. We are Bleachy Brave Souls and we share the Bleach Brave Souls experience, so I hope that you enjoyed here the video and the channel. If Remember to smash the like and subscribe if you did it. And see you in more news, in more videos, and on 27, the Bankai Live reveal, the end of month characters. I hope and I pray so much that I'm not gonna be very crazy and not make me summon so much, but looks as yes, I'm gonna be 1000 years of warfare and fuck us again. So, hope that you enjoy it, remember to share your opinion, what do you think about that news, what do you think about that leaks. Leave in a comment your opinion about the resurrections, about the returning banner, the Bankai Live, the predictions, and all the ding-ding-dongs. And have a good Monday! We are Bleach Brave Souls, and those are the leaks and the news. Take care, Bankai, and bye-bye! Bleach!